Hello, BZ. And hello, SMF Captain Howdy. John, in Canada, he's having a contest. That's awesome. A short and sweet contest, if you ask me. Not much to think about, but just to show albums from 1987. Because John has 1987 subscribers. Great thinking, John. Cheers again. Oh, this is great. I'm listening to the Montrose album that Blackmore Rules sent to me yesterday. As VCLT, speaking of VCLT, I am absolutely loving the Purple Rain picture disc, John. Thank you very much for sending that to me as VCLT as well. As a birthday present, it turned up at my birthday, so that was absolutely fantastic to have a fantastic picture disc like that, which I really wanted. So, back to the contest, John. And as I said, John wanted us to show albums or releases from 1987. So, let's go ahead. I have kind of split it up. I'm going to go for the 19 albums. John said that we could choose between showing 19 albums or 8 albums or 7 albums. I'm going for the full Monty, if you can say it like that. But I'm going to split it up because my taste in music have really, really changed from back in 1987 and now. So the first 9 I'm going to show is albums that I would listen to back in 1987, and the last 10 is going to be albums that I would listen to today if I could pick today. So I thought that was kind of a nice idea. Cheers, and again, it's weekend, Friday after work. There's not a better time at all. Cheers. As I said, my tastes have really, really changed since back then. Back then, I would mostly listen to pop music that were on the charts. So that's kind of it. So, and I said, my tastes have really, really changed. So let me just start with Richard Marx, his self-titled album, yes. Original LP at special price. But Richard Marx is one of the guys I would listen to back then. And Kurt Robin, maybe. That was also someone that we would listen to a lot back then. After Here Through Midlane is this album called. Yes, Kurt Robin. And Tapao. Also, this was a huge hit here in Denmark back in 87. And I actually saw her or saw them live years later at a festival. That was kind of cool. So, Tapao and Thompson Twins. Also, what's this album called? Close to the Bone. Thompson Twins were also a band that I would listen to a lot back then. And Erasure. I was hugely into electronic music, and Erasure were one of the best. So, Erasure Circus from 87. And here is a Danish artist, the film Coming to Your Heart Soon. And there's a kind of a nice story about this band. Take a look at the band there. This was going to be the next big thing in Denmark, and they were going to conquer the world and everything. So they spent 1 million Danish kroners on producing this album. So it sounds fantastic. Sounds like nothing ever made in Denmark before. So really, really great album, but they didn't make it at all. They didn't even make it here in Denmark. So not a lot of albums have been sold. And if you have the CD version of this album, which I do, it's worth a lot today. Anyway, the film from Denmark, Sandra, this is a compilation, but Sandra were one of the favorites back then too. I loved Sandra, both when we were having a drink and stuff like that going out. Let me just mention that I was 18 years old in 1987, so great stuff. And this were an album that we would listen to a lot back then, me and my buddies. It's a live album by Simple Minds, as you can see, but it has all the great Simple Minds songs. And yeah, we just used to listen to this a lot. Such a great live album by Simple Minds. And yes, Depeche Mode, Music for the Masses. I'm still a huge fan of Depeche Mode, so this is, of course, is also going to be in my list of music that we listened to back then in 1987. Great album. Yes, some of you might think, what happened to Prince, Sign of the Times? Well, back in 1987, I couldn't stand Prince, so I got into Prince later in life in the 90s, where I became a huge fan. So, for the albums that I would listen to today, not a lot of these albums are going to be put on my record player as it is right now. I'm on a huge metal and hair metal kick, so I would put on Abigail, but or by King Diamond. This is a reissue on a 2 LP set. King Diamond, Abigail. And King Diamond is Danish, for those of you that don't know. And also Pretty Maids, also a Danish hair metal band. This is their release, Future World, from 1987. Great stuff. Also Danish, Pretty Maids. Another Danish band, DAD. This was back when DAD still were called Disneyland After Dark, even though this is DAD, but they were still called Disneyland After Dark. I think I'll show you the inner cover on this one. Kind of like these inner covers from DAD, because Stigge, the bass player, which is that guy over there, he used to do all this writing on their covers, as you can see here. So yeah, DAD's release from 1987. I think this was their second release, second album. Oh my god, let me just put it back like that. Look at the back there. So DAD draws a circle from 1987. The next one, John Norum, his first solo album, Total Control. Kind of cool. Yeah, I know Blackstar Vinyl, Rob, has this on his want list, but it's mine, Rob. You can't have it. John Norum, Total Control. John Norum were or is again the guitarist of Europe. For those of you that don't know, he left Europe after Final Countdown, so, or were it the next album? Never mind. Manowar are a band I would put on now. Fighting the World. True metal. Manowar. They are so great, in my opinion. Over the top great. Manowar. And I'm also going to show the White Lion album, Pride, because I want to tell you, if you don't know, that the lead singer, Mike Tramp, he's a Dane. His real name is Michael Trampenau, or Michael Trampenau, as we say in Danish. But Mike Tramp is Danish. And for some of the albums that everybody is going to show, but I'm going to show it too. Appetite for Destruction by Guns N' Roses are also something that I would put on today from 1978. Dokken as well. Love these guys. Love George Lynch on guitar. He's a great guitarist, so Dokken, Back for the Attack. And I wasn't into Pink Floyd back in 1978, so it's something that I learned to listen to later. Even though that this is the first album that I listened to by Pink Floyd, but it was a little bit later, maybe in the beginning of the 90s or something like that. But this was my introduction to Pink Floyd. Of course, I have probably heard The Wall on the radio or something, but I didn't know what it was. But this was the first album that my older brother played for me when I knew it was Pink Floyd, and I was just, wow, what is this? Great album by Pink Floyd. And, of course, I would listen to Prince, Sign of the Times today. This is not my favorite album. My favorite album by Prince is Purple Rain, but this is Prince's best album. His finest hour, if you can say it like that. There's just everything on here. So, yeah, Prince, Sign of the Times. Back when a double album had 5 or 6 songs on every side, that is something to look up to today. That was it, John. I love this kind of easy contest idea, so you don't have to think a lot, just search for your albums from 1987. Of course, I could have showed a lot more, but this is just the ones that I choose to show. So, congratulations again, John, with the 1987 subscribers. Cheers, you are a great friend here in VC to me, so of course, I'm going to make a response. Cheers, and have a nice weekend, everybody. Bye-bye.